We're the Bronx, hello.
This is my neighborhood. I always say my neighborhood, like I own it.
We're very fortunate on 3rd Avenue. People come here for the best. And we have
all times love to eat, drink, and be merry.
We definitely don't suffer from a lack of good eating around here.
Go out all day and all night. You leave the house, you're 140 pounds. You came home, you're 177.
If you're not from this neighborhood, unfortunately, you're missing a lot of good things. Besides good people, good food, good atmosphere. If you notice behind us, we have Congressman Serrano. We have John Mariani over here, who's one of the famous writers.
Last couple of years, I represent this area, so I come talk to my friend David Greg, who I talk to the merchants here. It's an area that needs to be preserved for a million reasons, and one of them is the cultural value and aspect that is needed and kept alive right here at this market and throughout the neighborhood.
And the church played a big part. The church has been here 100 years.
My brother and I wrote this about growing up in the 1950s in the Bronx at a time when everything was just about almost golden. It was a great time to grow up. We had the most happy childhood. There's a whole section in the book, a whole chapter that I wrote about going to Arthur Avenue and how my father used to shop here 50, 60 years ago. Food actually gets better and better here rather than stays the same, which is remarkable.
This noodle cut is about at least 80 years old. My grandparents, they got their hands on this. When they opened up, 1935, they were able to get this. And it was kind of old back then. To demonstrate, putting this doll through the cutter and it comes out the other side. Nice fresh spaghetti.
We never remember not eating anything good. I remember coming home and you couldn't sleep on the bed because it was full of pasta. I want to take a nap. There was raviolis, gavadils, and Yorkies. You couldn't lay down. And God forbid you didn't show up for dinner. Like my grandfather's house, you weren't there on time. You had a problem. I don't care what you were doing. You were on a date with a girl. You had to leave. You had to be there because they got upset. My father wasn't the type of guy that would say, oh, how come you weren't here, son? He'd just smack it, boom, hit you in the head.
The restaurant's here since 1919. My great-grandmother started the restaurant. And then my grandfather, my father, myself, and my children are here. We're here 88 years this year.
I live here about 40 years, and I love it here.
I was born right there in the corner.
On the top of Tidal Brothers.
Right there, 186.
This is what's strong about this neighborhood, that these are good Americans who say, you know something? You could be a good American and a good Italian at the same time.
Can't beat that. The best combination there is.
I'm so used to this neighborhood and all my life. I just love it.